Okay, how many of you have some old CRTs sitting around that you don't know what to do with because you can't throw them away and you haven't yet gotten them out to the shooting range to blow them up, which is technically illegal in most places? You just don't know what to do with them. Well, instead of having them sit on your counter and take up space and be annoying, you could do something cool like turn them into an oscilloscope of sorts. Okay, so I got bored tonight and decided to take apart an old Dell monitor and see if it would cooperate with me. I disconnected the horizontal dispersion coil here with these two leads. It's nice, the pins just came right out. I was able to stick these two leads in there, in their place. But now this specific monitor has a cutoff for an idle signal. If the computer goes into sleep mode, then it'll trigger it to go the monitor go into sleep mode. So in order to keep the screen lit, I had to connect it to a computer that's running a constant output signal. Otherwise, it would go into sleep mode and fail to recognize the input that I've got across the dispersion coil here. Now, I could have, I actually tried at first swapping the horizontal and vertical dispersion coils such that I could get a vertical alignment of the output transform, but I actually tried that, and due to the resolution being non-square on this monitor, it actually gave me a very short band to work with. So this is what it looks like. It takes a little bit of time for it to get warmed up there. This is the reason it's got these bright lines in is that's actually the text on the startup screen for the BIOS coming through there, I think. It kind of brightens up a little bit if we tell it to display the on-screen menu. So anyways, what I've got here is I've got these two leads for the horizontal dispersion coil hooked up to a wire that is going into the left speaker out of a set of cheap amplified Harman Kardon computer speakers. Originally, I had it set up such that the audio out signal from the computer went straight into the wire, but the magnitude of the signal wasn't great enough to give much of an effect on the screen, so I decided to give it a little bit more amplitude by putting it straight into an amplified signal. What I found out through playing with this a little bit, if you can see this here, this is a test tone generator, and I've got it set at, put that 175.2, I think, is the base frequency here for this thing. And you can see when I do that, I get a nice steady output. And as I increase the volume, it increases the amplitude I can increase it to a point where the amplifier of these speakers starts clipping, and then you can see the distortion in the signal. What I found is that these speakers are actually only good to about 3/8 of their volume knob until they start clipping a little bit. It's kind of interesting. It basically, you know, if you know anything about harmonics and the octave scale, you'll know that if you multiply that 175 by 2 or divide by 2, you're just going to give us 350.4. If we put that into the test tone generator, sorry about the bad focus there, cell phone camera, it gives us a higher order wave there. And we can go up and up and up. But anyways, that's pretty cool and all. You could do a lot with that, but one of the cooler things about this is just, you know, playing one of your favorite songs. I've found that Dead Mouse Strobe is actually a really nice clean signal that looks pretty nice. So without further ado, I'll give that a little play for you. basically, you get the idea, but pretty cool. Play your favorite song, have fun with it. I guess if you do choose to take this on by yourself, there are some tutorials online for it, which is how I figured it out. Do heed the warnings. Be careful. There's a lot of voltage inside these monitors, so if your wires are not quite as easily as accessible as these were here, you may have to do some digging down inside the unit itself, where you could get yourself into trouble. So just be careful and have fun.